Being gracious. Please receive it by standing up and shouting a very loud Amen.
Hallelujah.
The title of my message once again is You Can Cross the Line. 1 Samuel chapter 14, verse 6. There are people who are living a life with an inborn problem. Jesus, that every negative inheritance in your life shall be disinherited today in the name of Jesus. Remember also in the book of John chapter 9 verse 1 to 7, there is a story of a man there that was born blind. When the man was brought to Jesus, the disciples of Jesus, they began to ask Jesus, who has committed this sin that this man is blind? Who has committed sin? Is it this man or the parents? Jesus said, neither of these, but the manifestation of the power of the living God. I prophesy in the name of Jesus that you will see the hand of God in your life, over your situation.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God ended that inherited problem in the life of a blind man and even in the life of a lame man. God end your own problem today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
He will work out His glory in your life.
Amen.
Not minding what people I've seen about you in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I pray for you now that every ancestral curse upon your life shall be broken today in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Point number two. Remember that point number one was the man was named from his mother's womb, which represents and inherited problem. Point number two, a man was being carried. They would bring him in the morning, drop him at that gate, they would stand afar, monitoring the money he's receiving. In the evening they come again to carry him. So the man was being carried. Can you imagine? The man was over 40 years and see Rodney carried from place to place. They say a fool at 40 is a fool forever.
Yes, sir.
What does this imply? Are you still depending on people for sustain? You should have sustaining others. God will change the story today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You have graduated from college, you have graduated from the university, yet you don't have any job. Men are still feeding you. God will cause a turnaround in your life today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Life, they say, begins at 40. A new life will begin for you today in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Point number three. Remember that point number one is that the man was sick from his mother's womb. Number two, the man was being carried. Point number three is he was lame. He was lame. What does it mean? It means inability.
Yes, sir.
Inability. I was praying for this message. The Lord took me back. An incident that happened. I had an accident and became lame. I said it severally, but because of this purpose that God has fulfilled today, you have missed in my life, God healed me. So when a man is lame, he becomes incapacitated. the man is lame. He becomes unable to do things he would have been able to do on his own. There are physical lameness and there are spiritual lameness.
Yes, sir.
He was not making progress because he was lame. His life was stagnated. In fact, people determine how far this man will go each day. On his own, he cannot determine how he will go. It was people that were determining for him how he is going to go. People determine how far he will go in life, where he will reach, where he will not get to. People can tell him, this week we are taking you to bed and collapse. People will tell you tomorrow we are going to take you to Dr. Jan. People will tell him tomorrow we are going to take you to this place. People tell him, no problem, we are going to just dump you at the back house so that you just be begging. He was lame. Ordinarily on his own, he would have chosen to go to a better place.
Yes, sir.
But he was incapacitated. A lot of people are incapacitated in life. They don't need the right thing to do, but
they are unable to do it. God is going to release ability to you this morning. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This man has no control over his life. He has no control. From today, I pray for you.
You will no longer be stagnated in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said you are moving forward in life in Jesus' name. I said point number one, the man was lame from his mother's womb. Point number two, the man was being carried. Point number three, he was lame. That means he was having a problem of inability. He was incapacitated. Point number four is that he was laid down at the gate. He was laid down at the gate. The gate is a place of decision making. Decisions were not taken in his favor. Even when at midday he decided to say, let me go and eat, his decisions were not meaningful.
Yes, sir.
They were needless. Probably when they come to the plate and they see that the plate is full of money, they can say, no problem, let's take the one eat today. If the plate is not full of money, is it still continuing to hustle? Or, okay, the money is not enough, let us buy you yam first. He was laid at the gate. He could not move to where he settled. He could not take decisions on his own. Decisions were not taken in his favor. He desired to enter the temple, but could not because he once carried him and decided where to replace him. Even when it might be that the people that brought him will come in and they will enter into the church, get their blessings, get their healing, but he was kept just at the gate. That is where the people, they are taking decisions over him. There are people standing at the gate of your life, taking decisions over your life. There are people standing at the gate of your life, determining thoughts where you will go. There are people standing at the gate of your life saying this is where you are going to get to in life. There are people standing at the gate of your destiny saying this and this and this are the places you are going to get to. I stand in the order of the word of God. Every power standing at the gate of your life, determining thoughts far you will go in life today, and you manage to fail.
Amen.
I say they are failed by your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There are men that can be seen with an ordinary man.
Yes, sir.
There are women that can be seen with the ordinary eyes. That are standing at the gate of your life, determining where you will get to now. Some might be your parents. Hello, I have told you, it will be an aberration for a Christian not to design your parents. Design them by the Spirit. Be a baby Christian. The Scripture says, the enemy of a man. The people of this household be seated. There are people sitting in high places determining the extent that you will go in life. The scripture says, this man was laid at the gate. They were using him to make money at the gate. They were using this man to make money. When power was present in the temple to cause a change situation, there was power in the temple. There was power in that temple. Why? Because Peter was there, John was there, those representatives of Jesus who were carriers of power, who were carriers of place, who were aware an ocean of healing virtue, they were there. But they decided to lay him at the gate. Turning him to money making machine. Amen. I pray in the name of Jesus. Any man or woman out there that has converted your life to MMM, money making machine, to ATM, may you not destroy them in the name of Jesus. Receive. Today I pray for you. Every decision that shall be taken by people around you shall be taken to your advantage in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Point number five. Remember that point number one is the man was slain from his mother's womb. Number two, the man was being caged, was being carried. The man was being carried. Number three, he was laid. Number four, he was laid down at the gate. And point number five is, he fixed his eyes on Peter and John. He fixed his eyes on Peter and John. I want you to hear this. Desire is the fire that makes you acquire what you require to advance in life. Desire is the fire that makes you acquire what you require to advance in life. No desire, no accomplishment. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
What is it that you desire? He fixed his eyes on Peter and John. He desired something. What is it that you are desiring? What is it that you are desiring? The scripture says in Mark chapter 11, verse 24. Mark chapter 11, verse 24. Check if you desire anything, what are you doing? You are doing. Have to pray. And after you have prayed, you should believe. Every power that will hinder you from making your desire to be an accomplishment, today shall be dismissed in the name of Jesus. Today shall be dismissed in the name of Jesus. He fixed his grace. He feasts his hands on Peter and John. And I said, that desire is the fire that makes you acquire what you require to advance in life. There are three things that happen to that man because he feasts his hands on Peter. Feasts his hands on Peter and supposed to have a testimony today. At about exactly 1:40 a.m. early in the morning, my phone rang. The next thing I heard, Daddy, I am dying. And the friend, the boys began to die. Children began to cry. Even the husband was incapable to take. But because she feasts her gaze on Jesus in the life of a prophet, let me come. Probably to be happy. And I said, you will not die. But you will live. To declare the work of God in the land of the living. You think of death. Loser! You will never be. The last time I kept, she called to say that maybe after that prayer, at the water you prayed on, I vomited blood substance and I started escalate.
Hallelujah.
If not, you are a good one. You shall not die before your time in Jesus' name. Any tumor, any human agent for that, an assignment to kill you, I decree to them in the name of Jesus, for your sake they shall die.
Amen.
It is written. In Psalm 7 verse 15, now whosoever thinketh a pit shall fall into that pit. Anyone that has dug a pit for you, because you are putting your gates, you are lifting up your eyes under the eyes from whence cometh your help. And because your help cometh from God, the Almighty God, described in Psalm 121, verse 1 to 2, I said, may they be buried in that pit. May they be buried in that pit in the name of Jesus. Be seated. Three things will happen to you after that. You will walk. Say amen.
Amen.
You will live. Say amen.
Amen.
And you will praise God.
Amen.
Can I hear your amen to that?
Amen.
Point number six. Remember. Point number one. The man was led from his mother's womb. Point number two. The man was being carried. Point number three. He was led. Point number four. He was laid down at the gate. Point number five, he fixed his eyes on Peter and John. And point number six is, he became a wonder. It is true. I used to be lame, but now I cannot only walk, I cannot only leap,
hallelujah.
I cannot only run,
hallelujah.
But I can fly.
Hallelujah.
He became a wonder. It was a testimony of that man that wrote the first 3,000 souls to the ministry of Peter. The testimony of on Sunday, somebody called me from Germany. Some other person called me from Italy, from different parts of the world. We are appreciating God for that family.
Hallelujah.
Even me that was here, I didn't even notice it. They were even angry. Say, why did that man allow that woman to sing? They were allowed her to express. They said, because the integrity of that testimony was expressed to that woman. That testimony is permanent in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Because I see that testimony causing an overflow in this ministry.
Amen. Amen.
And even in your life. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. In this ministry, we have recorded nothing less than 12 dead bodies brought back to life. We have recorded 7 insane people, mad people. And one of them is still using their mouth to speak against this ministry. I wonder. But the doctor that will cure that person is not alive anymore. When the person will run mad again.
Amen.
We have witnessed medical report being disclosed. We have witnessed people that have been given dates of death still living.
Hallelujah.
We have witnessed terminal disease being healed. We have witnessed 3 HIV cases being.
Glory.
We have witnessed cancer.
Hallelujah.
We have witnessed several testimonies. We have witnessed the dumb speak.
Hallelujah.
We have witnessed the. We have not witnessed the God. Very soon they will come.
Amen.
We have witnessed several testimonies. I declare upon your life.
Hallelujah.
And after this service, it will become a wonder in the name of Jesus. God bless you. We have witnessed somebody that was brought into the church with clutches. She came in with clutches. And the last time we checked, a minister of the gospel, she was rich enough to go to the best hospital. She came with clutches. Thank you for remembering this. And the driver held her up. But the driver was surprised that when she was coming out, the clutches were up.
Hallelujah.
What happened? She had an encounter. She became a wonder. The man at the beautiful gate that was had an awfully situation suddenly became a wonder. I said, you'll become a wonder.
Yeah.
I said, you'll become a wonder.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus! Why am I mentioning these testimonies? I've witnessed where babies that were dead in people's womb suddenly became alive. I was invited to a place thinking that I have testimonies in the house. I was invited by an affair. That the wife is about to give birth. They have been praying. They have tried a far way. They have tried Jabula, Jehovah. They have tried who? And they have tried Allah. But one of your daughters, the Lord said, you should come and try you. Me, I don't have power. That day they called me while I and my family were sleeping in the church, no house. Homeless entities were vested with the anointing to change lives. So we woke up that day. I quickly called my PM who was working somewhere. That day for the lawyer's PA, the people came and said there's an assignment. So that I found that people carried us. The wife was in labor. They took the wife to one hospital owned by a very good medical practitioner. The doctor was supposed to be a pastor. So when I came there, by the time we went to council, round about, I saw a bed, evil bed, in charge of the case, followed us. And God opened my eyes and said, okay, that is the case. So the case is a very serious one. Not serious before God in the eyes of men. By the time we got, as we were packing, the bed had gone ahead. But they asked, the building was towards a canal to land there. I said, let us see what you will do. I didn't go there alone. My senior partner went with me.
Hallelujah.
So I saw that they had done vigil overnight. They had prayed. They had prayed. And they disdained my presence. Who is this one? That time I used to have one native, only one native, brown color. that someone did not sow for me. I will never do it away from so they just get me. They put that on me. Now my PM saw me enter. They were saying, we did preach. We have done preach over this case. Is it you? You know, the man told me, he said, sir, I have told these people to go and bring money for surgical operation. What was the case? Holy Ghost drive. What do they call it? Immersive. What do they call it, man? Holy Ghost drive. No water in the womb for the baby to survive. They brought the scan. The scan was correct. Very, very correct. And the man was looking at this idiot. This idiot, top master. And I have to blame the woman, so we can't go back with she jack up. She knows that a man from God has come.
Hallelujah.
A man from God might not be a man from God.
Yes, yes, yes.
But a man from God is a man from God. I asked her, what is the case? Say that. I now send the affair, say, affair, you are trying your own way. Allow me to try my own way. I am carrying bottle of water. He ran to get bottle of water. But the man didn't stay there, you know. Two are facts. Holy Ghost are far. And I don't know who's their God. Of course, it's not my God. My God is not the God of the Muslims. Hear that clear.
Hallelujah.
My God is not the God of the Muslims.
Hallelujah.
So you have tried the power of the Muslim, they are called Afa. They call him all the way from Saudi Arabia. He didn't answer. So he brought the water, I prayed. I shook the water.
Yes, sir.
The way the Holy Spirit asked me to shake it. And I gave it to him, I said, shake it. And I left. As I was going out, a man looked at me again. He said, man of God. I am in medical. I have spent several years in the medicine. Secondly, I am a pastor with that church that starts with C and ends with C. The A at the middle. I will see the time. After 1 hour, they went to do tests. And the water was full.
Hallelujah!
That was called the only testimony. The same way the water was showed, the woman delivered with all the womb. So they had to arrange the womb inside again. I prophesied upon somebody.
I receive.
You know where I prophesied? Please give that woman my microphone. The doctor went back and asked my daughter, please, I want the church to hear. There was something the man asked her. But the lady questioned her younger sister. What did the man ask you, man?
He said, is this what called miracle?
He said, is this what a lady called miracle?
Yes.
What did you answer?
I said, it's a miracle.
This is what we call a professor. By the name that is above other name, that name of Jesus, you will become a miracle in Jesus' name. To become a wonder in the name of Jesus. I declare wonder. became a wonder. He became a wonder. The man became a wonder. After today's encounter with the Lord, your life will become a wonder to men.
Amen.
You see, before the encounter, the life of this man was a prayer point. Before that encounter, his life was a prayer point. Let me tell you the prayer point. People will look at him and say, God, let my case not be like this man's case. Whoever he has offended, may I not offend such a person. That was the prayer. But soon after the encounter, the prayer changed. He became God. Visit me as you have visited this man. Cause a turnaround in my life. I pray for you.
I receive.
In the name that is above every other name, your life too will soon become a positive prayer point to people in the name of Jesus. Your life will become a testimonial.
Amen.
Of answered prayers in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God will answer all your prayers in the name of Jesus. Amen. The singer, if there's anything I'm thanking God for in the ministry, is that I don't struggle. Even when I invite people here, they try to demonstrate power. We invite them because we want to change me. Tired of my life. Tired of this. Know that power is here. This is a hope of power.
Yes, sir.
In the Abara.
Yes, sir.
And say that to me.
Yes, sir.
It's a hope of power. Yes, sir. You know, I never may appreciate everybody in my second part. I saw that the ministers of this church.
Amen.
All the rest of the market, everybody, they have their own peculiar roots.
Yes.
You know, the blessed Lord in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The second point and the last. Remember, point number one, the man was slain from his mother's womb. Point number two, the man was being carried. Point number three, he was lame. Point four, he was laid down at the gate. Point five, he fixed his eyes on Peter and John. Point six, it became a wonder. And point seven is, Peter gave him the right hand. Peter gave him the right hand. God is going to stretch out his right hand towards you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Do you know that it is good to be right in life? It is good to be right. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 10, verse 38. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 10, verse 38. How God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good. Anointing is all about doing good. Anointing is all about stretching forth the hand. You will receive from today.
Amen.
Right things in life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Men will give you the right hand in life in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
In summary, the man at the beautiful gate was slain from his mother's womb. He was being carried from one place to the other. He was laid. He was incapacitated. He was laid down at the gate. The gate represents a place of decision making. Decisions that were taken were not in his favor. He fixed his gaze, his eyes on Peter and John. And the Bible said in 2 Corinthians chapter 20, verse 20b. 2 Corinthians chapter 20, verse 20b. He said, believe in the Lord your God, and he shall be established. believe in his prophet, he will prosper. It's an aberration for a member of this church. You are not believing God and you are not believing in me. Don't do that, please. You don't have my phone number, get it. Don't go home without getting it. I am a servant to you.
Yes, sir.
I am called to serve you.
Yes, sir.
Don't see you're calling me as a body.
Yes, sir.
God has increased me
yes.
with grace to carry people's body
yes.
by the power of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Don't pity me, pity yourself.
Mm.
Don't pity me, pity yourself.
Mm.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
He became a wonder. Peter gave him the right hand. There are factors that set a limit line to people in life. Many keep marching on this line, but cannot cross to the other side. Many get to this point, but they go back. They cannot get to the other side. This message will help give you the push that you need to get to the other side. No matter where you are now, there is somewhere better where you can be able to move.
Hallelujah.
Every position has its own allocation. Every position has its own allocation. Until your position changes, your allocation remains the same. Until your position changes, your allocation remains
the same.
God is set to take you to the other side of life. But the question is, are you ready to allow me now? Rise up on your feet. I believe God will share your heart. Rise up on your feet. I believe God will share your heart. Thank God for this message. Say, Lord, I thank you for this message. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name, we pray. I want to take a few prayer points. Please, when you are praying to God, close your eyes. The Lord said to me, he said, a set time, he said, all the while I have been establishing you as the church in power. Now, I want to start prospering again.
Hallelujah.
You are here. You need a job. Please see me. In fact, I won't go to my office once it's closed. You stay here and look. And please ask me. Stand to serve everybody. You can go to my office. Set time for God to bless you as well.
Amen.
I know that I have received testimonies of such people as I get to jobs.
Amen.
People as I get to be listening.
Amen.
Pastor, receiving contracts. Don't let your own pass you off.
Amen.
Are you hearing?
Yes.
I'm going to pray this prayer with your eyes closed. Say, Father.
Father.
Turn all my past failures.
Turn all my past failures.
Into success.
Into success.
In the name of Jesus. Open up my mouth. Father, turn all my past failures into success. In the name of Jesus. Say, my father, bring back to life every crippled relationship that is my lifting in life in the name of Jesus. My father, bring back to life every crippled relationship that is meant for my lifting in the name of Jesus. Bring back to life. Every crippled relationship that is meant for my lifting in life in the name of Jesus. Say, my father, I reject and renounce every negative hold and agents, covenant and agreement made by me on my behalf by my parents and my ancestors that is now working against my life in the name of Jesus. Say, my father, remove every yoke of bondage. Remove every yoke of bondage arising from family lineage
all dedication in the name of Jesus. My Father, remove every yoke of bondage arising from family lineage of dedication in the name of Jesus. Take every negative inheritance in my life. Be disinherited today in the name of Jesus. I pray for you that every negative inheritance in your life shall be disinherited now. Be disinherited now. In the name of Jesus. The message says, God ended that inherited problem. God will end your own problem today. Say, my Father, my Father, put to an end every problem in my life. Say, my Father, my Father, walk out your glory in my life. Open your heart and pray, walk out your glory. 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 Say, every ancestral curse upon my life, be broken today in the name of Jesus. I declare and declare upon your life that every ancestral curse upon your life, be broken. Say, my Father, from today, my life shall no longer be stagnated. In the name of Jesus. My Father, from today, my life will no longer be stagnated in Jesus' name. I pray for you. Your life will no longer be stagnated in Jesus' name. You shall move forward in life very much. Say, oh Lord God, my Father, from today, let every decision that shall be taken by people around me be taken for my advantage. Be taken to my advantage in the name of Jesus. Say, my Father, cause a turnaround in my life.
Oh,
have said, anywhere they see these singers, and they run away. So you are a great member of this church, and so I say that you are rich. And rich mercy from
our God.
And before I visit people's homes, I'll send my forward team to check. Don't have a secret. I will tell you what. Huh? Cannot pay for them, it's free. I'll be hearing. It's free.
I will draw the money all of them.
God will stand up. Send me the last prayer point. Say, Father, make my life.
Make my life.
A positive prayer point.
A positive prayer
to everyone around me.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Make my life a positive prayer point for everyone around me.
In the name of Jesus.
Make my life a positive prayer point.
You need a hand of fellowship. I will send a bitter, stretched forms, a hand, a right hand. Please come out. I don't know the area where you are suffering from weakness, maybe financial weakness, maybe spiritual weakness, maybe marital weakness, maybe ministerial weakness, maybe business weakness. Please come out.
Thank you.
the veil began to walk me from and flat. From today, I declare you will.
Amen.
In all ramification.
Amen.
Walk.
Amen.
Run.
Amen.
And begin to fly.
Amen.
In every endeavors of your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, for what you are doing in your hands. Let it be permanent.
Amen.
So you don't be on the floor.
Amen.
That from today I prophesy upon my life, upon their lives, we shall cross that line.
Amen.
Every of our desires shall become a reality.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I declare and declare prophetically upon your life and my life that those things we have been dreaming of to achieve, we are achieving them now.
Amen.
We are achieving them now.
Amen.
With our strength.
Amen.
With divine favor.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now we're moving to the next level.
Amen.
We are going to the next level.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Blessed be your holy
name.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.